A new proof has been announced, which they claim is the largest proof ever. It comes in two parts. The first part is this. This is part one, and part two is 200 terabytes large. That is huge. I'm going to start with something simpler, and something perhaps you can try yourselves. Okay, this is the idea. Let's take the numbers 1 to 9. I'm just going to draw them out in a grid here. Imagine these are the numbers 1 to 9. I'm not going to write the numbers in quite yet. And now I'm interested in A plus B equals C. So these are going to be whole numbers, and I'm going to have A plus B equals C. That's not a difficult equation. I want them to be different, so let's have A less than B less than C. Can I colour these numbers, 1 to 9, using red and blue so that I don't have A plus B equals C all the same colour? So I don't want them to be all red or all blue. That is something I want to avoid. So let's try this, see if we can. Let's start with 1 is a red. There's no reason why not. And let's have 2 be a blue. This means 3 is 1 plus 2. But that's okay, we can pick a colour. It could be red or blue. Brady, you could pick if you want. Do you want to be red?
Let's make it red.
Yeah, okay, fine. So we'll have 3 in red. Well, that's interesting because now we can make some deductions. 3 is red, 1 is red, so 4 can't be red. That's what we're trying to avoid. We don't want them all to be the same colour, because then we would have A plus B equals C all the same colour, or 1 plus 3 equals 4 would all be red. That would be something we're trying to avoid. That means 4 is going to be blue. That's right, 4 is blue. Great, but that's something we can use as well. 2 is blue, 4 is blue, 6 will have to be red. Let's put 6 as red. Well, that's interesting now, because we've got 1 plus 6 is 7. We're trying to avoid it being red. It'll have to be blue. Let's make it blue. 6 plus 3, those are both red, so I'm going to have 9 as blue. Okay, we're doing okay so far. I don't have a problem. Oh, but wait, there is a problem, because 2 plus 7 is 9. And they're all the same colour. Oh no, I messed up. I didn't do it. I failed here. This has failed. Well, there's lots of other ways of colouring in the numbers 1 to 9. In fact, each number has two options, red or blue. So it's going to be 2 to the power 9, 512. So there's 512 ways you could colour this in. It's not very hard for you to convince yourself that you're always going to fail. You're always going to end up with something like that. Or you could just check all the options if you want. You could check the 512 options and you will see that it's not possible to avoid A plus B equals C in the same colour. That's what this problem was about, but they took it one step further. They were interested in A squared plus B squared equals C squared. And they wanted to colour in the numbers using red and blue, just like we did before, but they wanted to avoid A squared plus B squared equals C squared being the same colour. So all being red or all being blue. Now you might recognise A squared plus B squared equals C squared. That's Pythagoras' theorem. But we're interested in whole number solutions for this. So a solution might be 3 squared plus 4 squared. That is actually equal to 5 squared. So we just check and that's, see if that's a solution. 3 squared is 9. 4 squared is 16. Add them together is 25. Great, because 25 is 5 squared. Another solution to this might be 5 squared plus 12 squared equals 13 squared. That is another solution that just uses whole numbers. These are called Pythagorean triples. They're not particularly rare. In fact, the ancient Greeks knew how to make them. I'll show you how to make a Pythagorean triple if you want. You just take two numbers, M and N, and what you do is A is equal to M squared minus N squared. So we're assuming M is the bigger one. B is 2M times N, and C is M squared plus N squared. And that is a Pythagorean triple. All you have to do is pick two numbers and you can generate a Pythagorean triple. There's an infinite number of them, absolutely. So this is a well-known thing. This is not the mystery. But the mystery now is, can we color in the integers using red and blue so that we don't get a Pythagorean triple in the same color? So imagine we have a blue set of numbers and a red set of numbers, and the red set do not contain a Pythagorean triple, and the blue set do not contain a Pythagorean triple. Now, there's lots of ways you can color your numbers. Is there a way to avoid this problem? So this is called the Pythagorean triple problem. Now, this is an application of something called Ramsey theory, and Ramsey theory is about finding structure in large number of objects. So if you have a large number of objects, is a structure unavoidable? Is it inevitable? Can you avoid this problem? Now, the answer is no, you can't avoid it. So what these guys have shown is that this is a solution that coloring the integers from 1 to 7,824. So they've split them up into red numbers, blue numbers, and you see the white squares, perhaps. The white squares represent numbers that could be red or blue, and it doesn't matter. So it would be a solution either way. But when they took it one step further, and they looked at colouring in the integers from 1 to 7,825, that's when it failed. That's when they showed that it can't be done, that you're always going to end up with a Pythagorean triple in the red set or in the blue set. This number, 7,825, is the straw that broke the camel's back. It's the last item on Bookaroo. It's the thing that broke it all down. The reason 7,825 broke the solution is because it's in two Pythagorean triples. Here they are, 625 squared plus 7,800 squared is equal to 7,825 squared, and 5,180 squared plus 5,865 squared is also equal to 7,825 squared. So what they found is that when they looked at the solutions for 7,824, and you look at all the possible solutions, 625 and 7,800 were always the same color. So they were either, let's say they're blue, and these numbers, 5,180 and 5,865, were always the same color and the other color. They were always red, perhaps, in this case, which means 7,825 now has to be red and blue at the same time, which is not possible, and the whole thing fails. And in the 1980s, our friend Ron Graham actually offered a prize for the person who solved this problem, the Pythagorean triple problem. He offered a $100 prize, which he has now delivered to one of the computer scientists at the University of Texas. He's delivered the check. He's paid up. So to show that this is a solution for 1 to 7,824, to show that is a solution and to confirm it's a solution takes seconds on a computer. It's not very difficult to do. But to show there are no solutions for 1 to 7,825, if you checked every possibility, would take a massive amount of computing time. The number of ways you could fill those in when each integer has two options would be 2 to the power 7,825. And that number is so massive, well, you could take a supercomputer, it would take too long for a supercomputer to check. Imagine all the supercomputers in the world, and imagine them checking all the possibilities since the dawn of time, since the Big Bang. You still won't be able to check all the possibilities. So that's not what they did. What they did is they used some clever mathematical tricks to reduce the number of things they had to check. They boiled this down to about a trillion things that they had to check. And that took them about 2 days using a supercomputer in the University of Texas. The only problem really with this type of proof is it doesn't increase our understanding of why this is true. What is special about the number 7,825? Why that number? These kind of proofs that require this huge amount of computation does not tell us anything about why something is true. And there is a conjecture that this will always be true no matter how many colours we use. We might use three colours or four colours. Now that number is going to get larger and larger. And the amount of computation it takes to find where it fails is going to be bigger and bigger. But to find a proof that shows it's always true, that's probably going to take traditional mathematics.
The Great Courses Plus is an on-demand video learning service with expert lecturers from all around the world covering all sorts of topics, from nuclear physics to Roman history. Now, of course, they've got you covered for mathematics. And this section here on trending and newsworthy topics is handy if you want a deeper understanding of current events. And look at this, dog training 101. That's right, Audrey, it looks like our weekend is sorted.
Yeah, you up for some dog training 101?
Now you can join a free trial with access to all the videos, including the dog training, by going to thegreatcoursesplus.com/numberphile. This is a great chance to dive deeper into the topics you love. And using the URL or the link in the video description will show them you came from Numberphile. Our thanks to The Great Courses Plus for supporting this video.
Thank you.